Okay, I'd like to call this finance committee meeting to order. Jim's on his way. First item we have is a assignment or request for council action. We have 1724, 2017 tax advances, 1725, transfer request to MCRC Capital, 1726, budget amendment, 1727, amending ordinance 13112, EMS agreement with Medina Hospital, 1728, donation of old computers to Medina City Schools, 1729, contract with Rain Associates, gap conversion and CAFR report, 1730, approve administrative office manager job description pay grade, 1731, expenditure for HG Supply Water Works Water Department, 1732, expenditure over 15,000 HG Umbon Associates, 1733, ODOT property acquisition for bridge projects, 1734, amending section 5.7 of the JOA regarding sponsorships, and 1735, 2016 carry forward. We have 1723, amending ordinance 5110, Memorial Park swimming pool rates. Mike?
Yes, I didn't.
Or who?
I'll take it.
Okay, what do you have, Scott?
So we talked about this pretty extensively at the public properties meeting. Mike and I would like to request to amend the ordinance 5110 to reflect the rates that I think are consistent with the pools surrounding Northeast Ohio. As we mentioned, we did surveyed approximately 10 communities in Northeast Ohio. Average entry fee was $7.50. The pool's similar to ours in size, ledge pool, and a pool in the township of Baltimore are both $7. We're recommending that we change the senior rate to $4, the lunch program daily admission to $4 for those that have a letter on file at the rec center. And a daily group rate of $4 and two and under would be free. For the seasonal passes, individuals could purchase it for $100 or a family pass with up to 5 members, which is consistent. With the rec center membership would be $200 and then $20 additional if they have a it's a family larger than 5. The lunch program rate would be $50 off either of those, either individual or family pass, as long as they have the letter on file. Those are kind of the set rates. Then we have the promotional rates that we discussed, where you can use a $5 punch pass that would be good at the outdoor pool or the rec center. You could purchase it for $5, so that would be a savings. If a mother and 2 kids showed up, they could, you know, essentially purchase a pass, a 5-card punch pass, and then use it either at the rec center or the outdoor pool. Early bird or special promotion pricing for signing up, probably like the end of April, we'd have to establish that, but not to exceed 25% off, hoping that we can get a lot of people to commit before the season starts, because to sell a pass out of the pool, not that we couldn't do it, it would just be a lot easier if we could get a lot of that done ahead of time, and help the residents out with the pricing. We're also requesting that we do a specialized limited time promotion to kind of take advantage of those days that are less than ideal for swimming, where attendance might be down. We can use our social media avenues, whether it be Facebook for the rec center, for the parks, or the actual page for the pool, to promote those, to hopefully avoid shutting down early. And then a mid-season special rate, which would be 50% off the season pass, obviously, because half the season's over. So we're hoping that with this new price structure, although it is an increase of where we were in 2012, knowing that we have a brand new pool with amenities that the old pool did not have, you know, everything from zero depth entry to a spray feature to a brand new water slide, we're hoping that we can try and recoup our operating costs with this fee structure.
Questions on that?
Question. Jensen, for the season pass rates, you said $50 off, but I have written here 50% off.
50%, yeah, sorry.
50% off, okay, all right, thank you.
Misspoke.
This is a question, why again did we adopt a rule that we limit a family size to five?
It's consistent with what is the current policy at the rec center.
And why do we have that current policy at the rec center?
That's just.
How many people do we have, usually families, do we have sign up that have over five members?
Well, we looked at this actually, yeah, we looked at this last time when we talked about we changed it that year to try to not one family going above the five.
All right, I was curious.
Of the pools that we surveyed, it was four was the most common requirement with the season pass. Anything more than four would be an extra fee.
I mean, I don't know how many families are out there with more than five members.
Just leave one kid home.
I guess.
Just to give you a little bit of insight, there were some recent articles written, and there was our social media pages, it was fairly well received with the current price structure. I know Falling Oaks charges $7. So I think we're pretty consistent with those around the area.
We were also able to look into the memorial pool, the rentals, you know, which Jim was asking about last public properties, and came up with some ideas and some existing ones that we were already using, like the 3-hour time slots for reserved pavilions and table areas, like if we take and rub off an area and say, okay, you can rent this area for a party or stuff like that inside the pool. So we had those times, and it'd be 3-hour time slots from 11:30 to 2:30, and then 3:30 to 6:30. Of course, the hours for the pools are 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. And then we'd also have the rental after hours and before hours, where they could rent the entire pool complex availability, like 8:30 to 10:30 a.m. or 7:30 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. And that's at a fee of $75 an hour, and then each additional guard or anything that we have to add on would be a separate extra charge.
Mike, are we providing the veterans any discount at the rec center?
We do not.
Didn't we at one point provide some kind of
we
discount?
We do active military, but when we talked to Zachary, or Zach, yeah, I actually called him and talked to him about it a few years ago, and he had said with the number of veterans that are in the area, it wouldn't be, that it's just a large number of people that would be getting a discount, and he suggested not doing it. So it's actually straight through the veterans very much.
And the
he'd like the active military to be able to, then they get a discount, $3 day pass instead of $7.
Okay. And then the seniors, the rates that you came up with, I mean, I see Ledge Pool, they offer for free to seniors. I know we can't do that, but I don't know, I guess a senior resident seasonal is $100, which I guess I'd like to see that be a little less than that myself, but I mean, I know it's not free, it's a little more than Baltimore Township, wherever that is, but I don't know.
It's about $1 a day. I mean, if you went every day for 3 months, you know, that senior rate, that's, I don't know, I don't know what the rest of you think, that I don't think that's too high, I mean.
And I understand exactly what you're saying. I mean, we all want to, we hate seeing the rates increase, but they have to. Our goal is to have the operations neutral. And I agree with that, like, especially I'm be one of the seniors, yeah. But
I like the senior rate and the veteran rate.
Right, there you go.
Well,
you can pay me to come.
I think one of the other things we talked about at the meeting there, between the sales, the early bird sales things, there's lots of opportunities to get a better price on things here too.
And I see that, but I just,
I guess, I know I came in late, but I just wanted to talk from Public Properties. I really want to thank Jansen and Mike and Christie for the research they did, because they, when they came to Public Properties, they had everything answered. They had looked at everything. I know from $4 to $7 seemed like a large amount from what it was before, but I think they did a good job of showing us why it needs to be that. I think we're trying to address the fact that we want this to be as self-sufficient budget-wise as possible. And I do like the opportunities between free and reduced lunch and passes and sales. There's punch cards. There's lots of ways to make this more reasonable for families. And when you look at Falling Oaks, I didn't realize they were $7, but I think what we offer compared to that, it's still pretty good entertainment value.
That's a tough one really to compare too, because I mean, Falling Oaks is a tiny pool compared to ours, and they're barely making it as it is. I don't know, I just threw it out there to see if there's any willingness to go a little less. But I mean, I understand all the work they've done and the other options that are out there, I saw that too. But free from $100, when we're comparison, I just didn't know, maybe 75.
And the other thing to remember we looked into too is the idea that, like when we talked about the $7 day passes, if, you know, we want to run a special, or, you know, we realize the $7 is higher, but it's easier to reduce the rate than it is to raise it later. So we go 2018 and say, oh, we should have had the rates higher. It's a lot harder to raise them. It's easier to run sales and do discounts and help people out through the lunch program now, so.
And it's going to be, I mean, we're going to have a new pool, so I mean, it's going to be a learning curve there too, to see what this new demand is, and if they like a new vibrant pool compared to what they had before.
That's why we want to have the opportunity to have sales, and we put it right in with there. If it's not working, we'll change it. You know, we have a 25% play.
I just think it's critical that we have, that it's financially successful first year. I think we, you know, we went through a long process to do this, and you know, it's expensive. And I think that it's important that, you know, we follow through on, you know, what you've got is a really comprehensive, responsible, well-researched, looks like a fair assessment, that we can come out of 2017 and be successful financially, as well as have, you know, have people enjoy the pool. I think that's a really critical part of this.
Any else?
Yeah, I have one thing.
Yes.
We did talk about the emergency clause at the public properties meeting, because, you know, 30 days from when this goes to council, we'd like to try and start selling passes as soon as possible with the season upcoming. Advertisement.
And that's where some of those sales will take place. I'm told a couple of people that kind of be watching for that, that there'll be some opportunities for. But move to approve with the emergency clause.
Second, including the emergency clause.
Any further discussion?
Yeah.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Aye.
So consistent.
So consistent. Paul said aye too. Next item is 1724 2017 property tax advance request.
It was part two.
We have to make a formal request to get advances. Property taxes were due Friday, so I have money to distribute now.
Questions? Move to approve.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. 1725 transfer request for MCRC capital contribution.
This is our transfer into this fund. We make annual.
Move to approve.
Second.
Any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. 17026 budget amendment. We have 7841 donation for the Engine House renovation project from the CDC.
I'll cover that.
Oh, Mayor?
So it's $15,000 from the CDC, but in addition to that, they paid $5,000 for the engineering and design of the upstairs renovation. So that $20 is coupled with a foundation donation of $20,000 from Murray Van Alp, who paid for the fountain at the Bicentennial Park. So collectively, we have the $40,000. I know Bill's working hard with the CDC. They're doing other fundraisers, the two movie premieres at Cool Beans was to raise funds. And we appreciate everything that CDC is doing. I think when we're partnering with the Career Center to actually do the labor, that's good and bad. It's good in that it's very inexpensive, and it gives the youth a chance to get some experience. The problem is the school doesn't go year-round, so we're going to get what we can done to May, and then have a 2.5-3 month break, and then wait for the next class to come in the fall and pick it back up again. But that, you know, that just kind of goes along with the program. Our bids have been good. We just awarded the electric bid at Board of Control today. It came in lower than we anticipated.
We've made some improvements along the way to try to stay within the existing funds and still have a usable rooms. I don't know, Bill, if there's other things you would like to add.
No, I think you really covered the money. It's a project that you guys know started in 1992, so this is really extremely exciting because the Career Center's done a great deal of the demolition. I think the material's on its way. We met this morning and worked out a couple final details that about what the roof looked like. And as I've told people, I was hoping that it could be done by the end of the school year, but if you look at starting in 1990, you know, an issue that came up and was worked on since 1992, if it goes into the fall and we're ready by the candlelight walk, you know, that'll be just a huge plus. And also, I think it's worth noting that I've spent some time with Roger Smalley, and we've talked about the ability to expand the museum upstairs and where things can go in the museum, and his ability to use the office that we initially were going to have for Main Street, that I think will be beneficial to, you know, be a big help for him and a big help for, really nice to expand the community museum that way. It's going to be good. And also appreciate the help from the Servinino and Dan. You know, I've had some involvement in it, but really those, Nino and Dan have been, they're like the engine behind it. You know, they've been here every time I've had a question or an issue, they've been right here to help out.
Yes,
appreciate that, Bill. Dan's been a great help. We all work together well. The other thing is the CDC paid for those plans, which I think we referenced. There's $15,000 donated here, then there was additional $5,000 that you paid for the drawings to the architect that designed the cul-de-sacs out for the renovation. So we appreciate it.
It's exciting to see some movement going here. So
yeah, it'd be really nice.
Thank you.
Move to approve.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. 17027, amending ordinance 13112, EMA Medical Services Agreement. Ray?
Thank you. This is the contract for LSD. It's a five-year contract. The last one expired, took effect in 12, expired in December 31st of 16. This is keeping everything the same within the contract and asking it to be effective from January 1st of this year and expiring 12/31 of 21.
Any other questions?
Move to approve.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Abstentions?
Aye.
One abstention.
Okay. Thank you.
1728, donation of old computers to the Medina City Schools.
I'll take that. So the city replaces computers on a rotation. We have 10 computers that otherwise would go to the auction. The school is in need of a number of these computers, 10 of the ones that we have. We have, I think, a little bit more than that. And the school has been very cooperative with the city. Mr. Rose has helped with this in creating a bank of computers that they weren't using. Actually a server there to duplicate everything we have here, so if something would happen to City Hall, an act of God or whatever, we could bring those computers up and in a short order operate the city out of a room over at the high school. Originally we were going to copy those over periodically, and with the fiber line that we have shared between the school and the city, we found that it's easier to just keep it live rather than do it incrementally. So that this means that at any given time, if something happens here, we can go there and vice versa. And you know, our hope is, and working with the schools and their IT folks, is to be able to offer them something similar, if we could, here to house at City Hall, things to support and back up the schools. So. We fully support using these. When they're done with these 10, we then get them back, and then they end up in the auction for the amount of money we get at the auction for, and we're not really losing anything by letting them use them for a few years.
I need to abstain since it's my employer.
Okay. Favorable motion, second. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Abstentions?
Aye.
Motion carries. 2000, I mean, 1729, contract with Rand Associates, preparation of gap and caper. Keith?
They've been doing this for a number of years. This goes up $500 a year, which is not significant given the amount of the contract. I'd like to continue with them.
And the emergency clause, Keith, do you need that?
Yes, because filing deadlines, we have to get things, they have to get some work.
Do we, oh, I mean, well, the letter was September. Is that, was that the wrong date? I see in the letter it was September of 2016. You got this? But I guess I'm confused. Was that when it was originally sent? Do we need an emergency then, really? I guess that's the question.
I don't know that we got it in September. We may have, but if we did, we should have brought it here sooner.
Okay. Move to approve with the emergency clause?
Second with the emergency clause.
Any questions? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
Aye.
Did you vote no, Jim?
Yeah, well, I vote no for the emergency clause. I vote yes for the ordinance, but.
Okay.
But we didn't separate.
Stay consistent, though.
1730, approved job description and pay grade for administrative office manager. Mayor?
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Mr. President. So we actually, with Dawn giving us her notice to leave the city here in the next couple of months, what we did is took a look at all of the job tasks as happens over time. The last time this was revised was in 2011. Some jobs are added, some are eliminated because of technology and other things, or somebody else assumes those. So we want to make sure that the job description was up to date. The other thing that I wanted, when we go to fill this position, is some flexibility in the pay range. As it was, the highest rate is where Dawn is currently. And if we hire somebody with less experience or somebody that has to work into the position, it didn't seem proper or correct to start them where Dawn is. But I wanted the flexibility of being able to move them then as they learn the job and develop the skills. So those are the major changes. We did add in the job description as well the preference for graduation from college or a university. It's not mandated, but it, we just feel it gives them a more well-rounded perspective. And there's two different job descriptions there. The first one doesn't show the changes. The second one, the changes are highlighted in the darker print, so you can see what was either struck or what was added. I respectfully ask you to pass that.
Questions?
Move to approve?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. 1731, expenditure to HD Supply Water Works for the water department. Nino?
Thank you, Mr. President. So every year, we purchase the water system maintenance supplies, water breaks, and various job tasks. Parts range anywhere. A clamp, for example, is $250. A tapping sleeve, $750. We go on a repair, you know, pipe and gate valves, you can look at $1,000, $2,000. So it doesn't take long, you see with 60 water breaks, to accumulate the kind of expenditures we do. So we're asking to accept this, get us through the year with water maintenance.
Questions?
Nino, what did we do last year, send them up?
We did. We came to Border Control, we were shopping prices, then we have to up the amount. So we talked with Kathy, and this was the most simple, the amount, I think, was about $50,000. It's close. We started with $45 at this point.
Any other questions?
Move to approve?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. 1732, expenditure over $15,000 to HJ Umba TIF project. Kimberly?
Thank you, Mr. President. This request is for contract for municipal advisory and economic development consulting services as it relates to the City of Medina Downtown Development TIF project. And the project plan and timing is still needs to be determined, but it is expected to include the development of private improvements and public infrastructure, including the public parking decks. So this is really a follow-up to our previous conversation that we had with UMBA Associates when he came and presented, I guess, about a month ago. I did also provide a copy of the contract to the law director for review and approval, so I guess we should make it subject to that. And I had not originally requested emergency plug. I don't know if we need that or not, but.
Well, what does everybody think about the presentation? Any comments about that, or?
I thought it was, I was glad we got to see it. I think it really kind of sold it.
Does everybody agree that that's pretty much the only way to do this public improvement is to get paid through?
Right.
The reimbursement of the development that occurs because of it?
Yes.
Kimberly?
The only question I have is, the chamber property, previous chamber property, I know we wanted to possibly include that into this project. Do you have any ideas on construction time for them, or, because you may need the emergency clause?
I think he wants to break ground within the next month and have his project completed by the end of the year. But this is not contingent on that, because the value isn't really going to occur until.
Until after it's completed?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, but.
Then answer that question.
But with that, we should still get started on this, because there will have, we have to really determine what parcels we want to put into that, so that Brian could calculate what the increased value would be based on the developments that are going to occur.
Understood.
And ideally, we would like to include that parcel if possible.
So it needs emergency?
No, she says the.
Doesn't need it.
The value would hit the tax rolls in January 1st of 2018. So as long as it's done before then, we're good to go. If it takes us longer than that to pass the TIF ordinance, then we get a problem.
It does not have to be before construction.
That was clear.
Because it's under 25,000, it doesn't have to have a.
Doesn't have to go to.
Yeah, it doesn't go to council, it has to go through finance.
Can we do an RFP or anything for this?
We did not, but I guess the question is, I mean, there's not many people who do this, and Kimberly, I think you did your check, and then he's one of the most reasonable.
Yeah, I got two quotes on it, so this one was less money.
His services are good for how long?
How long is his services good for?
Well, it's for the length of the project. Now, if we want.
Entire project.
If we want them to be, if we want them to, once the TIF is implemented, if we want them to do annual monitoring, which at this point, I don't know that we're gonna need that, but if we find out that we need that, then that's gonna be an additional fee. That's not included in here.
Well, my concern is that we're gonna spend $20,000, which is justified, but, you know, we talked about the chamber property and how long is it gonna take for the other properties to develop, and will we still have him as an option, or do we, you know, is it gonna be so far down the road that we're gonna have to.
Well, I think we're gonna have an executive session next meeting to talk about that.
Or are we putting the cart before the horse then, or?
No, maybe, no.
Okay.
I think we gotta get it going and get that one piece, and then maybe some other things that we wanna.
The other thing too, we can recapture.
His fee.
These expenses through the TIF, if we choose to.
Right.
Which I would recommend, since.
So if you wanna capture, not only the cost.
You're going on the chamber property for now, as to get the ball rolling, but.
Well, that's what all has to be determined, or is.
All right, I just wanna make sure that we're gonna have this service long enough to.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Before we have to throw any more money in, before some of the other bigger projects.
There'll be other projects, but we'll talk about that.
Yeah.
Executive session. So, yes. Is there any other questions?
Move to approve.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carries. 17-032, and this is coming from your JED funds, I think, right?
Yes.
Initial money? Yeah. Check on it, man. 17-033, ODOT property acquisition for bridge projects. Patrick?
ODOT selected two bridges in the city to reconstruct, rebuild. One of them on North Harmony, one of them on West Smith. They selected these, and they are funding them 100%. for each one of those, because of the existing right-of-way, they had to acquire additional right-of-way and/or easements. They've been negotiating with property owners for quite some time. We were notified, I think it was the end of January, about two parcels, one on each project. They were unable to come to an agreement with the property owner. We got submitted a package to Greg Huber, requesting that we file to acquire those easements. They did include a check for the appraised amount of the value. Indicated to us that we need to get this done as soon as possible or risk losing the funding for the projects.
We need to pass this today so that I can file these complaints tomorrow. I've been told by ODOT that if we don't get the authorization from the court to enter the properties by the end of this month, we may lose the project. And the problem with that is, depending upon what the judge decides to do with the motion for permission to enter the properties, we may not get that authorization. It's up to the judge, and so we'll have to see what takes place in the next couple of weeks and what the judge decides with respect to giving permission for us to enter the two properties in question by the end of the month. A little bit disturbing because the negotiations stopped with these property owners in August, and this paperwork sat in the ODOT desks from August until a week ago when somebody just came in and set two envelopes down on my desk and walked out. I didn't know what they were in. Opened them up and got on the phone and learned that we're all of a sudden backed into a corner on these two projects, which meant calling John to get this on your agenda and asking for permission to move quickly on this.
For the council's benefit, I talked to the deputy district director at ODOT 3 and told him that how this was presented to the city with this time limit of the end of the month was just not very rational. And he apologized and said that it had fallen off somewhere at their office. They're making the necessary corrections, but the time limit is the time limit to use the funds that they've been given. They have to meet that time constraint or give it to another city that can't. So we're under the gun for this one, but he is putting things in place so that we don't. First of all, to just bring something in and lay it in an envelope and not address it with anybody. I said if Greg had been on vacation for a week, right, nobody would have ever opened those. And the second concern is that if you guys knew in August this was going on, why are we not getting it until the first week of February? And then, by the way, we need it by the end of the month. So
I mean, I've reviewed all the information that was provided in our packets and appreciate all the hard work that the administration's done to, and everybody else involved, to try to compromise here. And I think you've gone above and beyond to try to be reasonable. And I mean, I understand the property owner has rights too, but you would hope that they'd be willing to compromise. And what they put in front of us, to me, is their opinion, but I'm fine moving forward tonight with the emergency clause.
Yeah, because this will go to finance, right, to council.
That's fine.
Anybody have any other comments or questions on it?
Pat does.
Pat, you do?
Just quickly, just to give you an idea of the dollars involved, ODOT has packaged these two bridges and one other bridge that's outside the city and one of the townships together. They combined that contract is about $1.6 million. So assuming each one is about a third of that, the total dollar amount here is over $1 million improvement in the city.
Okay.
I move to approve with the emergency clause.
Second, including the emergency clause.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? What carries? Kathy, question for you. Do we talk about the changes to the JOA agreement here? Because that's the next one in my packet, but not on the agenda. Was that supposed to be on the agenda?
Oh.
Probably? Okay, we'll talk about it.
yep.
That is I think we're talking about 17034, amending section 5.7 of the JOA regarding sponsorships. What?
Yeah, that's per the school's request with the work session February 6th, and the schools had requested that we change those, the words from naming rights to sponsorship rights, because it conflicts with a program they have for naming rights. So it really wasn't a big change for us. It was just going through and scratching out naming rights and putting in the word sponsorship. And then, if at all possible, okay. The RFP that's on today's council, wanted to request, if we could request to do an emergency clause with that. We've had a couple sponsorship, a couple companies want to do sponsorships call us in the last 2 weeks since it was in the paper. Three companies plus two firms that would like to look at the proposal for marketing. So rather than wait the next 30 days, it's already been a two-year project. If we could, I could at least request an emergency clause for that year.
That's on, I think that's 1417, right? Yeah, that's the sponsorship rights from the last finance meeting. There was no emergency clause attached to that. He's requesting it. What does everybody think?
I'm okay with it.
Mixed feelings, but I don't want to make an example out of Mike. But, you know, these emergency clauses, I think we need to tie them back a little bit. Or
I appreciate it. Don't have
out of control.
You can delay things as long as the council would like. You just tell us.
Sometimes I think.
What's assuming that?
We'll just let them go.
That's assuming that we get them in on time.
Yeah, I mean, that's all.
Well, right.
That's the other thing.
I mean, most of these things we bring down is not because it's been sitting on anybody's desk for a period of time.
Sometimes I think the emergency clause is one issue, but if you look at the business sense of what cities do now in order to operate, it's so complex. And there's so many different things that have to be funded or operations that have to take place that in a business that you wouldn't, there is no emergency clause. You just do those things. And I think that's where this has come into play. I think that's more the case than somebody just forgot to bring, you know, or chose not to bring it in time.
I don't have a problem with it.
I don't either.
Can anybody else agree?
I'm going to abstain, so.
I move to approve the sponsorship, the change in the wording of the sponsorship on this request, and also request the emergency clause added.
Second.
What?
No, we don't need the emergency clause.
This is tonight. We're going to have to do an emergency clause on item 1317 on the council agenda.
On the council agenda.
Which has nothing to do with this one, but.
Never mind.
Second without the emergency clause.
Do you want to just go and do it anyway, Mark?
Yeah, sure, Bill.
Are there any other questions?
No.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Abstentions?
Aye.
Motion carries. Last one here then is 1734, 2000 and...
35.
What?
No, 35. Sorry.
35. 2000 and... yeah, wait a minute. Yeah, 2016 carry forward. Keith?
These are the unspent 2016 appropriations. As you know, we had some issues with general fund because we have a lot of advances outstanding, but we've gotten some of that money back in the meantime, so we're okay now.
And everybody went through their carry forward. That's how you got all this information. I think you talked to everybody, all the department heads, right?
This is what was available, what we were minus the lines that were pulled out.
We used to have separate
weeks. Put in where they
Rich did.
Right.
Rich did ask the department heads, and some of them, you know, refrained from taking all.
Refrained. I like that word.
How'd that go?
That's probably Nino, mostly, right?
We're just glad to see council.
I think it was Nino.
Okay.
Yeah.
We wait 6 months.
All right. Any other questions on that?
Do we ever, when we used to have separate meetings to talk about carry forward?
We've been talking about it.
We talked about it. Every budget meeting, we talked about it. When we saw the amount on the project.
And this is where they reported.
So it's $2.1 million we're talking about over all the departments, which I think is pretty good. Mm-hmm. It's less than 10%. It's probably what, 8% or something, 7%? Okay. So the total
budget?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Move to approve?
Second. Any questions?
Two is the difference between what was available and what was requested. The total you're appropriating here is 7.2.
Oh, the difference, yeah, you're right, I'm sorry. Total report is 7.7, right? The original report total was 9.8. I'm sorry. I read the bottom number.
Ken told me to think you're voting on 2 million, you're actually voting on 7.
Yeah. So, a lot of those are already covered, those projects. Unless you want to cut those projects. Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Okay, now we have to go to executive session.
Right. Okay, I'm going to make a motion then that we enter into executive session at 6:43 PM for the following reasons. One is to consider the employment of a public employee or official. Two, consider the purchase of property for public purpose or the sale of property at competitive bidding because premature disclosure would give an unfair competitive or bargaining advantage to a person whose personal private interest is adverse to the general public interest. And for, also for preparing for and conducting review and negotiations or bargaining sessions with employees concerning their compensation or other terms and conditions of their employment, to include the mayor, to include Craig Huber, and Nino Piccoli, service director.
And I have one more, imminent litigation as well.
And also for imminent litigation.
And who is coming?
The mayor, Craig Huber, service director Nino Piccoli.
That's it, three of you guys?
Yes.
For all four of those things, okay.
Second.
Okay, we'll be, oh, clerk, please call the roll.
Lamb.
Yes.
Hilbert.
Yes.
Shields.
Yes.
Wayne.
Yes.
Simpson.
Yes.
Rhodes.
Yes.
Yes.
We'll be recessing into executive session. We'll be coming back from executive session, but we're taking no action on the executive session items. We'll be adjourning from that and adjourning the finance meeting after that.